Hello everyone, so myself Venkat Harish. So today we will discuss about the concept, the basic mechanical engineering. So purely the subject is related about for civil engineers. So in these topics, majorly what we are discussing means completely basic concepts. So it includes the different concepts like design, thermal, kinematics, refrigeration, so everything basics we will cover for today's class. So coming to the main concept, that is course objectives. So from the concept, from the subject, what we can understand. So what are the content available in the topic? That is units means very first thing. First we will understand the basic machine elements. So what are the requirements of the machines? The basic operations. For corresponding each and unit, we will discuss the basic concept with respect to the machines and their operations. So next, the source of energy and power generation. So how the power we are generating? By using this, which kind of phenomena or tools or theories. So that corresponding information we will discuss one by one. So coming to next, the various manufacturing process. Of course, the civil engineer requires the basic idea about the manufacturing process. So what are all the machines we are using, tools we are using? So what is the principles we are considering? So that we will discuss. And finally, the power transmission elements and material handling equipment. So after transmission of power, so what we have to do? We have to store. So for storing means we have to transfer the power. So how we have to transfer? So what are the tools we require? So that we will see with the layouts. And finally, the material handling equipments. So what is the flow diagram? So how the process has to be executed? So that we will see one by one in the diagram. Next. So after completing the all units. So after completing each and every unit, so what we have to understand? The first one, to understand the mechanical equipment for the usage of civil engineer systems. So how we have to use effective components. So by using their basic principles that we will understand at the end of the each and every unit. So next, to familiarize with the general principles and requirements for the refrigeration and manufacturing concepts. So what are the refrigeration principle? That is Carnot principle, reverse Drayton principle. So everything we will discuss one by one with the PV and TS diagram. And finally, to realize the techniques employed, construct civil engineers for the system. So what are all the requirements is required for the equipments or tools for the final transformation and construction purpose. So that we will understand at the end of the unit. Next. So coming to the syllabus. So it contains completely the 5 units. So each and every unit, it is completely about only the basic concept. So in the first unit, what we will understand about the camps and followers. So the why camps is required. So where it is applied. So what are the applications, advantages and everything we will discuss one by one. So after that, coming to the engineering materials, heat transformation. So how the heat will be generated? So how it will be transferred? So what are the types? How it will be transferred with basic principles? So that we will see step by step. After that, the riveted joint. So the riveted joint is nothing but one of the joining process. So we have different joining processes are there, but we are using here only riveted joints. So when the object is connected with the rivets, so when you apply the loads, so what kind of stresses it will be generated? So how the failure will be created? So that we will see the one by one with respect to the diagram. So coming to the second unit, here we are discussing about the power transmission elements. So what are the tools we are required for power generation and how it we have to transfer from one location to the another location. So coming to the next, the terminology about the spur, helical and bevel. These are all nothing but a power transmission concepts. So coming to third unit here, the power generation. So how the power we have to generate with respect to the reference principles, that is refrigeration, heat transfer, Carnot cycle, that we are discussing in the third unit. So coming to the fourth unit, it is about the manufacturing process. The manufacturing includes different methods. So that nothing but sheet metal, welding, fabrication, casting. So different process we are using with respect to the layouts and corresponding machine with the different operations and tools. And finally, the fifth unit is about the machining, machine tools. So whatever the components we are generating, so we are using with respect to the standard machines like lathe, drilling machine, grinding machines, milling machines and the respective parts and operation. So each machine, we will understand what are the components are there. So what are the operations we can perform with respect to the machine and their advantages applications. So coming to the first unit, so today we will discuss about the CAMS. So before entering into the CAMS concept, first we will understand why it is required and where it is used. So the CAMS majorly used for conversion of rotary motion to reciprocating or linear motion. So that is the animation, so we can understand clearly the rotation motion from the shaft. So that is converted to the follower up and down movement. So this connection, this mechanism we are majorly using in our two wheelers. So two wheelers and four wheelers. So whatever the operations of valve opening and closing in the internal combustion engine, that is completely depending upon the CAMS and followers. So coming to the small animation regarding the internal combustion engine. So this is the cam and follower mechanism. So the inlet and outlet valves, the inlet and outlet valve opening is completely depends upon the cam operation. So based on that operation, the suction, compression, power stroke and finally exhaust stroke will be performed by the internal combustion engine. Next. So these are all small examples about the cam and follower mechanism. So next. Then the cam, it is classified in different mechanisms. So based on that first shape. So based on the shape, it is classified in different mechanisms. So depending upon the application, we have to select the different types of cams. So that we will discuss the first concept. Second one is the follower movement. So whether the follower moving with a constant rotation or constant speed or offset distance along the axis. So that is again depending upon the follower motion. So next one, according to the shape. So according to the shape, how it is classified, how it is transferred. The first one, the wedge and flat cams. So the name itself indicates the cam and follower connection. Observe the cam and follower connection. It is a different kind. So one is spring attached, another one is roller connection, another one is guide movement. So based on the application, we can use the different kind of the mechanism. So next is the radial or cam disc. So the cam should be in the form of the radial or disc method. So different kind of applications, different kind of locations, you can select the different types of cams. Next. Okay, this is about next, the cylindrical cam. So this is the small animation about the follower and cam. So the rotary motion which is converted to the linear motion. So that is the diagram. Here the follower which moves in the slot of a cam. So it is a cut section here generated. So next, according to the follower motion. So the follower, it will be moves in the different kind. So that is first one, the RRR method. So RRR method is nothing but rise, return, rise. The graphical representation is clearly shown. The R indicates the rise, return, rise condition. Means in this concept, so there is no dwell portion. So dwell portion is nothing but a rest position. So continuously increasing, continuously decreasing, continuously increasing, decreasing. The increasing nothing but the rise position. The upward direction is nothing but a rise. The downward direction is nothing but a return. So in the first concept, there is no rest condition. So but there is a second method, there is a dwell portion is available. So dwell portion is nothing but a, there is no movement. So there is a flat movement. So that's why it is indication the flat line. Next. So the third one is DR, DRD, nothing but dwell, rise, dwell, return, again dwell. So here it is again, we are getting the two dwells and one rise and return concept. So the complete, the cam is 360 degrees. So that 360 degree, we are represented in the horizontal line. So X and Y line. So Y line indicates the upward lift. So horizontal indicates the dwell portion, rise and lift angles we are represented in the horizontal. Next. So coming to the classification of follower. So till now what we discussed about the cam and cam classification. So next is about the follower. So the follower, first one is according to the surface contact. So what kind of contact between the cam and follower? So in the cam and follower connection is, there is a only point contact. So from the diagram it will be clear, the cam and follower is only the point contact. So that is one of the knife edge follower it is. Next. So next it is the roller follower. So in the place of knife edge, we are just replaced with one small roller. So that is the difference. There is no other changes. So cam and roller follower animation. So next is about the flat face follower. Only the surface contact that will be differs. It will be in the line contact or point contact. It will explain whether it is flat or knife edge or roller follower. So this is about the small animation about the flat face follower movement. So during the upward and downward movement, it will be clearly understand. Next. So next is final one, that is spherical follower. So again the contact between the cam and follower is only spherical type. So that's why it is another type of contact. Next. So next, according to the motion of the follower. So again, the what kind of motion we are generating. So the previously what we discussed, that is according to the type of surface contact. This is according to type of motion. Whether it may be offset follower or knife edge follower, roller follower, again flat face follower. So again subclassified will becomes along the axis or offset. So that will be the next. So this spherical face follower. So next coming to the according to the path of contact of the follower. So again it is nothing but whether it may be along the axis or along the offset. So along the axis means the knife edge and follower and cam follower will be along the same axis, but the offset means there is a small distance from the axis of cam to the axis of follower. So again the offset will be classified the different types, that is knife edge, roller, flat face and spherical. So the whatever the types will be the same, but the concept whether it is along the axis or along the offset distance. So this is about the animation of roller follower. So one more very important. So at finally we have to draw a cam path. So how the cam has to be generated the path. So for generating the path we have to remember some key point, nothing but a major points, that is what are all the points we require to generate the cam profile. So the cam profile, it contains the different concepts. So in that very first one, the base circle. So the base circle is nothing but a, it is a main circle and which is the smallest circle for the our selected cam. So that is the reference point. From the reference point only we have to generate the cam. So from that reference we will discuss the one by one process, that is the trace point. So the trace point is nothing but the whatever cam path we have generated. So that path is generated with the help of a trace point. So the combination of trace point is nothing but the finally our required cam profile. Next. So next coming to the pressure angle, pitch point, pitch circle, pitch curve. So all these are represented with the reference of trace point only. So next, prime circle lift. So prime circle is nothing but the final cam circle. So after that the lift is nothing but the maximum possible movement of a follower. So upward direction maximum distance is nothing but we are calling as a stroke or lift. So next, the motion of the follower. So the motion of the follower we are represented in three methods. So the whatever the displacement, velocity, acceleration, what we are representing, that is purely depending upon the three methods. First one, uniform velocity, simple harmonic motion and uniform acceleration and retardation. So each and every concept there is a set of rules. So how we have to consider the values. So how we have to differentiate, how we have to split into the dwell, rise, return. So everything we have to with the standard angles. So that we will discuss the one by one. So very first thing is displacement acceleration diagram by uniform velocity. So in the uniform velocity concept, so what we have to consider, so how we have to represent the diagram. So first, before going into the direct diagram, first we will understand, so what we have to maintain along the x-axis and y-axis. So along the x-axis we are representing the cam movement. So we already saw the different types of follower motion, that is rise, dwell, return, dwell. So majorly we will get the four concepts, that is rise, dwell, return, dwell. So all these distance we have to write with the help of angles.